Hello students, how are you? Today we will discuss about Moseley law. Moseley law determined the nuclear charge. In 1913, Moseley performed a systematic study of characteristic X-ray of many of 45 elements. He used these elements one by one as the target in X-ray tube and measured the wavelength of K alpha, L alpha, X-ray of these elements. As we discussed earlier, in X-ray spectrum, K alpha, K beta, K gamma, L alpha, L beta, L gamma, M alpha, M beta, M gamma, X-rays are exist. Moseley performed the experiment or he studied about only K alpha and K L alpha lines. He noticed a striking regularly in the spectral line of each series. The spectrum of X-ray emitted by one element is similar to the other, except that the line have different wavelength. That is, we can say that the X-ray spectrum is similar for all the lines, but having different wavelength, this is different. Further, we can say that it was observed that the frequency of line in a series varied regularly from one element to other, or he observed that the frequency of the line in the series varied regularly from one element to next in the periodic table. On plotting the graph between square root of the frequency of any particular line, say K alpha, and the atomic number Z of the element emitting the line, then a straight line is observed. The variation root of mu, that is square root of the frequency or square root of 1 by wavelength and atomic number for the K alpha lines is like this as the straight line. Similarly, he observed it for L alpha line, the graph between square root of the frequency and K alpha of any particular atomic number Z for the L alpha, the graph will also straight line. On the basis of this observation, Moseley conclude that square root of the frequency of a particular spectral line is proportional to atomic number of the element emitting the line. This statement is known as Moseley law. The straight line showing the variation of square root of the frequency with atomic number do not pass the origin and has non-zero intercepts. Therefore, the variation of square root of frequency and atomic number mathematically can be written as we can say that here square root of the frequency and atomic number gives the straight line for K alpha and L alpha lines, and for these lines we can say that root mu is directly proportional to atomic number, that is Z. But this does not match with experimental results, hence Moseley included in this and modified this as root mu is directly proportional to Z minus B. Hence we get mu is directly proportional to z minus b whole square, and a is the directly proportional constant, and we can say that mu is equals to a into z minus b whole square, where a and b are constant. For the k alpha lines, the value of a is fixed. The experimental results shows that for the k alpha lines, the value of a is found to be 3/4 r, and the value of b is nearly equal to 1, whereas here r is Rydberg constant, hence c is the speed of light and r is the Rydberg constant. So the and also it is noticed that the value of b is nearly equal to 1 for k alpha lines. Therefore, for the k alpha lines, this equation mu is equals to a into z minus b whole square becomes mu is equals to 3/4 r c z minus 1 whole square, and we can rewrite it as r c z minus 1 whole square 1 minus 1/4, and we can return this as 1/1 square minus 1/2 square. This equation is similar to the formula of the frequency of spectral line of hydrogen atom obtained from the Bohr theory. Hence, it shows that K alpha spectral lines, in the K alpha spectral lines, electrons jumps from orbit to it shows that for K alpha spectral lines, electrons jump from orbit of principal quantum number 2 to the principal quantum number 1. It should also note that from this equation, there is a factor z minus 1, whereas from the Bohr theory, we accept in factor z in place of z minus 1. In the Bohr theory, there is z. The difference lies in the origin of K alpha lines. When an electron is knocked from the K cells of electron to the K cells of electric field of plus z e charge of nucleus and minus e charge of single electron in the K cell, so that the net charge is z minus 1 e during the emission of K alpha lines, because one electron is ejected out from the atom. So Mohs-Leylà can be expressed as, we can rewrite this as, or we can express this in term of wavelength, as we know that mu is equals to c by lambda. Put here, we get the results. For determination of the nuclear charge, we measure the wavelength lambda for k alpha, that is the characteristics of the X-ray obtained from the X-ray tube in which the target is given element, and corresponding to the value of wavelength, the value of Z is determined from the graph is a straight line between the square root of the frequency and atomic number. For the different elements, K alpha lines for the different elements, then the nuclear charge of the given element will be plus ZE. This is the nuclear charge. How proves the Mohs-Leylà? From this experiment, that is, the nuclear charge always is plus ZE.